Oh, yes. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We worship you. What can wash away my sins?
Nothing
but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again?
Nothing
but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white. No, that I found, I know nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, yes. Oh, my God, in this I see nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my sins and this I plead, nothing but the blood of Jesus. And all precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. Oh, at the fount I know nothing. The blood of Jesus. Raka de boje branda zende de be. Raka da da ba zende de be de biya da ba. Hara da ke mane de borundo biya da ba. Da borundo. This is my hope and peace. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. This is all my righteousness.
Nothing
but the blood of Jesus. And oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. At a fount I know nothing. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you for yet another day. Thank you for how far, Lord, you brought us. It is not by mind, it is not by power, but by your spirit. We give you glory. We honor you, Jesus Christ, for such a wonderful time. Master, speak. Your children will hear it. As we abide before you, as a servant, look to Master, a servant. Unto the mistress. So we have come to look to you. Speak to us, Papa. Speak to us in Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, we bring you greetings from God the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Everywhere you are listening to us, is our prayer that the Lord God will bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord open the heavens unto you. May he cause his face to shine upon you and give you peace. The Bible says, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Again, it says, for all things are purged by blood. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Jesus Christ came to die to save us by the blood of the Lamb. And the word of a testimony that he overcame the enemy. The Bible said there was a war in heaven. And the dragon, this Satan, fought against the angel of the Lord. And he fought against him. And the dragon could not find a place in heaven. And was cast down. And the Bible says in Revelation that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. And the words of his testimony. Jesus shed his blood that we may have life and have it more abundantly. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord God gives you victory in everything you are doing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Have you been to Jesus for a cleansing power? And are you washing the blood of the Lamb? Oh, are your garments spotless? And are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Oh, are your garments spotless? And are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Have you been to Jesus for a cleansing power? And are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Have you been washed by the blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? The Bible says that Zacchaeus heard about Jesus Christ. And so, the life that became the light of man is passing by. The Savior of our soul, he ran and climbed a sycamore tree. The Bible says when Jesus got there, Jesus told him, today I will abide in your house. Somebody, Jesus is passing your way. Revelation 3 and verse 20 says, I stand at the door and knock if anyone will hear me. If somebody will hear me and open me, I'll come in and I'll die with him. Jesus is passing your way. Jesus is passing your way. My brother, my sister, Jesus is passing your way. It's my prayer, wherever you are listening to us, that you allow yourself. The Bible says, with the heart we believe, a mouth confession is made that Jesus Christ is Lord. He's passing your way. There is a song we used to sing and we continue to sing. Jesus is passing this way, your way, my way. Jesus is passing your way, is passing your way right now. Greetings to you, Mama Jenny Sacrofi. God bless you, woman of God. Jesus is always passing our way. Ready. He stands at your door and knock. If you open him, Jesus will come in and die with you. There is no other God. My brother, my sister, one day our Jesus will show up. One day our Jesus will come. It is not what you want. It is not what you are saying. It is what the word of God is saying. Greetings to you, Apostle. Nana Grovy, my brother. Bishop, God bless you. Your mama, greetings to you. It is not what you are saying. It is what the word of God is saying. Our Jesus will come. And the Bible says he will come in his glory. And if he comes, where would be your place? Somebody says, I don't believe it. Yes. Why will you believe it? Jesus told Mary and Martha, if you believe, you'll see the glory of God. One day, we all will stand before the judgment seat of Christ and we'll give accounts. We give accounts. Save us. Master, the prayer of the disciple. The disciples cry that save us. Save us, Lord. My brother, my sister, Jesus continued to save. The Bible says in Matthew 7 and verse 7, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Call upon him. If you call upon him out of a pure heart, he saves. Jesus continues to save. But how many people realize it? Because we look to the world, we look to some men and women of God, we look to the people around us,
and our faith sinks. Our faith sinks. Believing that there is no God. I don't believe there is a God. My brother, my sister. Jesus, through his servant John on the island of Patmos, wrote a letter to the churches. And to every church, he said, they that have ears, let them hear what the Spirit says. And I every day say, not everybody have the ear of the Spirit to understand the things of the Spirit. Except those who allow themselves. Except those who allow themselves. One day our Jesus will come. And if he comes, where will be your place? May the Lord bless you. May the Lord God open the heavens unto you and cause you to walk and continue the storms of life. Jesus was in the boat. Jesus was with the disciples. Yes, till there was a storm. A storm raged. The tempest raged. Thinking that they were not going to survive. My brother, my sister, child of God, in this life you survive. Hey, many are the things that we go through. But the Bible says everything work together for good for those who love God. There is a condition for those who love God and those who are called according to his purpose. It will work together for good. Your Jesus is with you. My Jesus, the one who died on the cross, the one who said that he was going to destroy the temple and raise it back again in the third day. I talked about storms. One, I said that storms are inevitable. That you don't have choices. Storms don't say you are rich. Everybody goes through different kinds of storms. My prayer is that the storms of life that you are going through, you'll be able to stand. Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. The Bible says we should look to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross. Jesus endured the cross. Let's endure. Let's hold on. One day, he will show up in his glory. Yes. Hallelujah. The second one I talked about, that following Jesus Christ can lead you into storm. Following Jesus. Hallelujah. You see, I have critically studied the Bible and some of the characters in the Bible, and all of them in the Bible went through different kinds of storm. Not because of the sin they committed, not because of anything, but because of coming to the Lord. My brother, my sister, following God will lead you into a storm. People have died because, hey, many villages have been burned. Many people have been burned alive. Why? Because they follow Jesus Christ. They accepted Christ as their personal savior. And so following Jesus Christ will lead you into storm. The disciples, they follow Jesus Christ. Let me go and read our scripture for the day. Matthew 8. Matthew 8. And I read verse 23. And just say, he says that, but Jesus said unto him, follow me. Verse 22. And when he was entered into the ship, his disciples followed him. Following Jesus Christ will lead you into storm. Because the devil don't want you to believe that there is a God. And every day tells you, if Adam and Eve knew the consequence of their action, they would have not eaten. Yes, the devil did not let them know. That is why many people don't want to believe it. Because they have been shown the pleasures of sin of this world. But the consequence have been hidden from them. Except through the Holy Spirit. Except through the Holy Spirit that is being revealed. And my prayer is that the Spirit of God reveal to you that you run to the Lord Jesus Christ. Save us. And the third thing I've been talking about is some of the storms that we go through. They are tests of faith. Test of faith. And yesterday I talked about the measure of faith. Testing. Where everybody is tested according to the measure of his faith. And I talked about the manner of faith testing. How our faith is tested. And the third thing I talked about was the meaning of faith testing. What it means. And I said, God tries our faith to prove how genuine our faith is. There are many people, when you come to God and you pray the same day and your prayer is answered, After you receive it, you will not come back to God. You will not come back to God. You will not come back to God. My prayer is that somebody that is listening to us, that you know that faith is right to prove our genuineness that we have. The second thing is that God tries our faith to increase the measure of it. To increase. Job was tested. Job said he knows the way that I'll go. When I come out, I'll come out as gold. Again, he said in Job 13:15 that though he slain me, yes, will I trust him. To increase our faith. Many people were tested. Abraham was tested. My prayer is that whatever storm that you are going through, whatever problem that you are going to, look to Jesus. Hold on. Hey, there is a light after the tunnel, at the end of every tunnel. At the end of every tunnel, there is a light. The Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Joy comes in the morning. I understand that joy comes in the morning. One day the joy of the Lord will show up in the glory. Let me go and read 2 Corinthians chapter 4. And I'll read verse 17 and 18. Somebody listen to it. 2 Corinthians 4 and the verse 18. Listen to the word of God. It said, for our light affliction. The affliction, the problem that you are going through. The thing that you are going through. My brother, my sister, hold on to Jesus. Jesus said, be still and know I am the Lord. Be still. Be still and know I am the Lord. It is very sudden that many people have come to the Lord in the midst of pain, in the midst of struggle, they begin to run away. Seek other means. And my prayer is that you hold on. He knows the best for you. He knows the best for you. Yes, what you are going through is not easy. It is very painful. But hold on. Hold on. He said, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment, work for us a far more exceedingly an eternal weight of glory. Eternal weight of glory. Our light affliction. Somebody will say, so for this is not light. I remember I heard a story about a pastor. A pastor who, if somebody is bereaved, he goes there and console the person. Give it to God. Give it to God. God knows it. God gave. And if God have taken. And they said the pastor's wife died. And everybody went to him and was consoling him. He said, this is not what we give to God. My brother, my sister, every day say that. Yes, nobody can feel your pain. Nobody can feel your pain. They just imagine it. Somebody will come to you. Oh, I can feel your pain. You cannot feel it. You cannot feel it. You just imagine it. My brother, my sister, you know what you are going through. You know you have the pain of it. You have the pinch of this. But I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you'll be able to stand. You'll be able to stand. God tries our faith to secure the preciousness of it. How precious. The Bible says that we were saved by grace. We are more than precious. Gold, when you want to get the gold, it pass through fire. And the drone of it, everything. You separate the bad from the gold from the dust to receive it. And so our faith is so precious. And God tries our faith to produce a fruit. And finally, God tries our faith to use it as a testimony. Many a times, God, the things that we go through becomes a testimony. Paul was testifying. When you read Paul testify, 2 Corinthians 11:23, going, the things he went through. Many a time, that is the reason why we go through storm. Let me talk about some of the characters in the Bible. That were faith was tested. Their faith was tested, but they won. They won. They went through storms, but they won. The other day I talked about John the Baptist. Today I want to talk about Simon Peter. Peter, a man who was called, a man who followed Jesus Christ, one of the 12 disciples of Jesus. Peter is known for his boldness. My brother, my sister. Storms will come into your life. At times we go through storm to test our faith. Have faith in God. Have faith in God. Again, have faith in God. The Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. For by faith the elders receive good report. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. My brother, my sister, you go through storms. Hey, not everything will be right with you, because you don't invite storm. Jesus told us, 1 Peter chapter 5, in the verse 6, he says that we should humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. The verse 7, he said, cast all your burdens on him, for he cares. When you come to verse 8, he said, be sober and be vigilant. A child of God, meaning that open your eyes and be watchful, because your adversary, the devil, is roaming like a lion seeking somebody to devour. You don't invite troubles. Trouble will seek for you. Trouble will seek for you. Because nobody calls for a storm. When the storm or the hurricane comes, the hurricane don't choose that because you are a rich man. Or the storm comes, the snow comes, you don't choose that because you are a rich man, because you are white or black. Storms happen to everybody. But where you build your house, Jesus told us and likened us in Matthew chapter 7 and the verse 24, that whoever hears the word and build is like one who built his house on the rock. Build your faith on the Lord Jesus Christ. Build your faith on the Lord Jesus Christ. You'll be tested. You'll be tested. You'll go through. But hold on. Let me tell somebody, Jesus is with you. Again, know that Jesus Christ is with you. He will never suffer your foot to be moved. He is with you till the end of this world. Can somebody say amen? Your Jesus is with you. Isaiah 41 and the verse 10, he said, fear not. My brother, my sister, child of God, fear not. God said, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yeah, I will help thee. I will uphold thee with my right hand of righteousness. Behold, all they that increase against thee shall be ashamed and confounded. They shall be as nothing, and they shall strive with thee shall perish. They that strive with you shall perish. This is the word of God. This is the word of God for them that trust in him. Jiradidi. Christo di Jiradidi. Jiradidi. There are many people that have come to our Lord Jesus Christ and they don't believe, because your faith is like a rolling coaster. It's like an empty can in the river, hitting everywhere. Hold on and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says he is with us till the end of this world. Peter was one who was commanded by Jesus for receiving the revelation from the Father that Jesus was the Son of the living God. Go and read Matthew 16. Go and read Matthew 16. Jesus asked them, who do people say I am? They said, some say you are a prophet, some say you are John the Baptist, some say you are this. And Jesus said, who do you also think? Then Peter shouted, you are the Son of the living God. Then Jesus turned to Peter and said, not flesh and blood reveal it to you, but my Father in heaven. Upon you I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall never prevail. I have given you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound. My brother, my sister, let's hold on to Jesus. But yet still a storm hit Peter's life. When he told Jesus that everywhere he will go with him, he was trying to show his face, his faith. Jesus told, by the time the cock crows three times, you deny me. Peter said, no. Now I'm not going to deny you. My brother, my sister, there are many characters in the Bible that went through. John the Baptist sent them to go and ask if Jesus is the one to come. He prophesied. He baptized Jesus Christ. Yes, though, troubles will hit you. Storms will come in your way. If your faith is grounded in the Lord, that is what Jesus said. It's like somebody that built his house on a rock. Storms will reach, tempests will come, and the buildings still stand strong. But if your faith is not built on the rock and on the sun, little thing will drive you away. Then you begin to roam from one pastor to another, telling them to prophesy on you. Prophets are lie. They are all sorcerers. Most of them, about 99.9%, they are sorcerers. They are not prophets. They are not prophets. They are not prophets. They are evil. My prayer is that you hold on. Somebody said, Pastor John Hickey said, God is closer to you as your next prayer. He's closer. God is not distant from you. He's closer to you. He will help you. He will uphold you with his right hand of righteousness. Let's hold on to our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's go and look at Luke chapter 22, and I'll read from Luke 22 verse 54 coming, and let's see when Jesus was arrested. When Jesus was arrested, we're going to see Peter, a man of faith, what he went through. 54, he says that, and they took him and led him and brought him into the high priest, and Peter followed afar off. Then, and when they had kindled a fire in the midst of the hall and were sat down together, Peter sat down among them. But a certain maid beheld him as he sat by the fire, and earnestly looked upon him, and said, This man was also with him. My brother, my sister, our faith will be tested. Our faith will be tested. Let's hold on. He said, this man was also with him. And he denied him, saying, woman, I know him not. I don't know him. I don't know this man. But Jesus, Peter was the one who was following Jesus. But he denied Jesus Christ. He denied and said, I don't know him. And he denied him, saying, I don't know him. And after a little while, another saw him and said, thou art also of them. And Peter said, man, I am not with him. And about the space of an hour after, another confidently affirmed, saying of the truth, this fellow also was with him, for he is a Galilean. And about the space of an hour, and Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately while he yet speak, the cock crows. And the Lord turned and looked upon Peter. And Peter remembered the words of the Lord, how he had said unto him, before the cock crows, thou shalt deny me thrice. He denied him three times. And Peter went out, wept bitterly. He wept bitterly. Storms of life, our problems we go through. At times it builds as testimony. We are reading. We're reading some from many of them. Hold on to your faith. Don't see your storms as something difficult. It is gaining a testimony for us. We want to live and testify. Hold on to your faith and pray. Do not cast your faith. Hallelujah. Let me go and read Hebrews chapter 10, and I'll read verse 35 and 36. It says, cast not away therefore your confidence. Cast not your confidence away, which has a great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. After you have done the will of God, be patient with God. Many people are wondering, many people are wavering, many people are crying because of the things that come your way. It is gaining a testimony for you. It is building a testimony. One day you stand and testify. Jesus was with them in the boat. But yes, still the storm came. The storm, they did not say, because Jesus was in the boat, we are not going, because this man is so powerful, and he will tell the storm to be quiet. Yes, it came. And they thought they were perishing. How far have you come in life that you think you are perishing? What has hit your doors, your life, that you think that God is not with you? My brother, my sister, we have a God. The song goes, we have a God who never fail. We have a God who never fail. We have a God who never fails. Who never fails forevermore. Amen, amen. Jesus never fail. Amen, amen. My Jesus never fail. My Jesus never fail. The one who died on the cross. The one who said, it is finished, on the cross. He took the mantle and told us, oh, power and authority in heaven on earth has been given unto me. I give it to you. Go in the power of the Holy Ghost. My brother, my sister, your day of glory will come. Always remember, as Russell Grandy say, one morning you see the glory of God. If you don't waver, if you don't give up, if you don't throw in the towel, if you don't leave your faith somewhere, one day Jesus will crown you. The old rugged rock song. It's only hill far away to that old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. When he ended, he said, one day we will lay down our pains and our trouble for a crown. Except those who have the Spirit of God understand. They have had a revelation in the Lord, understand. And one day we will turn our pains and trouble for a crown. Hold on to Jesus. Hold on. You see the glory of God. It is gaining a testimony for you. It is building a testimony for you. Another man whose faith was tested, it was Elijah. Elijah the prophet. Elijah from nowhere came and told Ahab, but my word is not going to rain. Yes, when you read the Bible said there was no rain. Because the Bible says effectual fervent prayer of the righteous man availeth much. James wrote it. James 5, read verse 16. He said Elijah was a human, 17. Elijah was a human being with same like passion, but he was able to lock the heavens. Meaning that he command power. And God told him, go and show yourself to Ahab. I am going to bring down rain. Let me ask you, what are you going through? My brother, my sister, what are you going through that is causing you to run from one place to another? Enter your closet. Matthew chapter 6 and the verse 6 says, when you want to pray, enter your closet, close the door and pray in your closet. The God who sees you in your inner closet will bless you openly. How many people pray? Every Christian knows that prayer works. People come to me and ask me, what have you seen God show you about me? Immediately I tell them, God said, go and pray and wait patiently. They get angry. They want you to lie to them. That is why we have many people that lie. They will lie to you because of your money. But thank God that some of us, we want to show you the way to Christ and the way to heaven. We want to show you the way. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 18. The Bible said that God told Elijah, go and show yourself. I am talking about the characters in the Bible whose faith were tested, but they won. They won. Hold on to Jesus Christ. Storms of this life will come. Many are going through. Sometimes the job, your job, you lose your job. All of a sudden you lose your job. Sometimes your husband or your wife can leave you. Without no reason. And you ask yourself, why? What sin have I committed? You may think that maybe sometimes your child will get sick. Sometimes a dear one will depart from you. And you ask God. It is very sad. Some of the troubles it weighs. Some of the troubles that we go through. At times you would say that, Where is God? Where is God? I remember when I was kept in this secluded place, and this innocent man, I've done nothing wrong. And the whole world was mocking, and some were happy. I bowed down my head and I was crying every day. One day I called my twin brother, and he said that, why are you crying? Take the word of God and begin to preach yourself. That was the strength that God gave to me to keep me through. Keep me through, Lord Jesus. Keep me through. Keep me through, Lord Jesus. Keep me through. There is a race that I must run, and a victory is to be won. Give me power every hour to be through. There is a race that we must run, brother, sister, and there are victories to be won. God, give us power every hour to be through. May the Lord grant us power to overcome. Every hour and every second, look to Jesus. In our end time, nobody want to hear anything about Jesus Christ, because the devil don't want you to come. He's working faster. Many theologians, many scholars, many people are denying Christ. No wonder when he was choosing his disciple, he did not go to the seminary. There were seminaries. He did not go to the army barracks. He did not go to the palace. He went to the shore. The Bible says he chose the foolish things of this world to shame the wise. That is why some people will tell you, oh, he is a sinner. He has done this. He has done this. Thank God. They said the same thing about Zacchaeus. Go and read Luke chapter 19 and verse 10. Jesus, the Bible says, he said, he came for the sinners. I have never seen anybody who is not sick and will just stand up and go to the hospital and see a physician, except those who are sick. And so we sinners come to the Lord Jesus Christ, and he turned our life around. He has turned our lives around. Somebody say, he turned my life around. He turned my life around. You can sing it for me. It makes a way where there seems to way. Jehovah. Yes, I've forgotten the song. You can sing it for me. Jesus will turn your life around. It's only Jesus Christ. Hold on, don't cast your faith. Don't give it. Don't let anybody exchange your faith. Live a righteous life. Live it. One day you see the glory of God. I every day smile. I am the joyful person on earth. I am telling you, I am the happiest person on earth. Somebody will say, why? Because every day within my heart, I hear and I feel the still voice of God always rejoicing. Our Jesus is real. Our Jesus is real. Everybody, they went through one other day, but they hold on. Elijah prophesied. And verse 18, the Bible says that he told them, bring all the prophets. You know how many prophets through Elijah they killed? 850. 850 prophets were killed. Greetings to you, Rana Sona. God bless you. 850 prophets they killed. Elijah was healed. Oh, Elijah. Why? He called fire from heaven and fire fell. The Bible says, let me go and read verse 39. 1 Kings 18 and verse 38. Then fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering and the wood and the stone and the dust and licked up the waters that was in the trench. And when all the people saw it, they fell on their face and they said, the Lord is God. The Lord is God. And Elijah said, take the prophets of Baal, let none one of them escape. And they took them, and Elijah brought them down to the brook and slain them all. He slain all the prophets. Slain all the prophets. What a mighty, and everybody was clapping. But there comes the trouble. There comes the affliction. There comes the afflictions. It comes. The Bible says, when Jezebel, the woman heard, Jezebel heard that Elijah, First Kings 19 and verse 1. And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done. And withheld how he had slain all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a message unto Elijah saying, so let the gods do to me and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about that time. And when he saw that, he arose and went for his life and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah, and left his servant there. And he himself went the journey into the wilderness, came and sat under a juniper tree, and he requested for himself that he might die. He might die. I am talking about songs of life. Some of the men and the women, you go through the Bible, you see all of them, their faith was tested. Mordecai sat, when Naaman told them they were going to kill Mordecai, going to kill all the Jews. Mordecai was a prayerful man. He went and sat in the street and was crying. He cried like a child. He torn his clothes. Go and read Esther chapter 4. He torn all his clothes. But the thing to my Jeffrey never. My brother, my sister, the child of God that is listening to me, have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Your storms will subside. Jesus will speak to your storm if you know him. The Bible says all things work together for good for those who love God and those who are called according to his purpose. according to his purpose. Let me go and read Romans chapter 8, and I'll read verse 35. Hear the word of God through Paul. He said, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? What is separating you from the love of Christ? Christ on your team, and then I tell you, Christ on them. The manager won't be if you are sana. The woman says that she's not going to marry. Yes, when you are going through, no amount of words can comfort you and console you. No amount of words can comfort you and console you. But look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. Our Jesus is faithful. Many people have come to Jesus and they don't know who Jesus is. Because we have had corrupt men and women of God. They have not seen, they say, Jesus said. They have not, God has not spoken to them, they say. And many people, through divination, through sorcery, through evil spirits, they are performing wonders. Jesus said in Matthew 24, in the verse 24, that many will come and say, I did this with your name, I did this with your name. But even they will deceive the elect of God. Don't allow anybody to deceive you. Choose Jesus. Choose Jesus. I every day will tell you, if you go to a church whereby you will not receive your salvation, if you continue to sit in your sin, that you sit in your sin and go to hell, leave the church. Go and find a place where you hear the word of God, the message of the cross, that you always will not sit in sin. Live a repentance life. Live a righteous life. Strive towards perfection. And hold on to the garment of Jehovah. Our Jesus is faithful. Our Jesus is faithful. He will come. Our Jesus will come. So who will separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation. It is easy for tribulation. Tribulations are troubles. Troubles that comes our way. Many people run away. A little trouble. They don't want to worship God again. They don't want to come to church. Sometimes you hear people. Somebody asked me, Pastor, when I was in the world, everything was good for me. The day I accepted Christ, troubles all over. I said, the devil wants to tell you that there is no God. The devil wants to tell you it was better to be in the world than to come to Christ. But in him is life. If you want life, it's in Jesus Christ. If you want joy, it's in Jesus Christ. That is why the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is our strength. We take our joy from the cross. Take it. Don't let tribulation, don't let distress, don't let persecution, famine, nakedness, fear, or the sword. It is written, for thy sake we are killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for slaughter. Nay, in all things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Jesus loved you. You are more than a conqueror. The tide will subside. Your weeping will stop. Job will come in the morning. The glory of God will shine. That is my prayer for you. Now you see the glory of God. Keep on. Somebody sang a song and said, would your anchor hold in the storms of life? When the clouds unfold their wings of strife, when the strong ties lift and the cable strain, would your anchor drift or firm remain? We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure, whilst the billows roll, fast into the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. Oh, we have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure, whilst the billows roll, fast into the rock, a rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. Who would your anchor hold, brother, in the storms of life, when the clouds unfold their wings, their wings of strife, when the strong tie lifts and the cable strain, would your anchor drift or firm remains? Mama, my brother, we have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure, whilst the billows roll, fast into the rock, a rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. Be grounded in the Savior's love. Ground yourself in Jesus Christ. Nothing. We are more than conquerors through him who saved us. Our Jesus is alive. Our Jesus is alive. The world don't want to hear. Nobody want to hear. We continue to sound the trumpet, call the world to come to Jesus Christ. Nobody want to hear. They don't have ears. Let them hear what the Spirit says. Our Jesus is alive. Our Jesus is alive. Elijah, the Bible says he left and told God. He laid and slept under a Joppa tree. Behold, then an angel of the Lord touched him and said unto him, arise and eat. And he looked, and behold, there was a cake on the coals and a case of water. And the angel of the Lord came again the second time and touched him and said, arise and eat. Behold, and the journey is too great for thee. My brother, my sister, the journey of life is not long. But believe you me, there are many things that will go on. Because the devil always wants you to know that there is no God. There is no heaven. And so, and to soil and destroy your faith. Keep it, hold it. One day, at times, I understand the troubles and the pains that we have gone through. The things that we have gone through. Now I have an understanding of it. Because Jesus wanted to use our life to win souls. To win souls. And so the devil wanted to kill us premature, destroy us premature, disgrace us premature. But our God is always alive. He said he's with us. Our Jesus is with us to the end of this world. My brother, my sister, Jesus is alive. The angel of the Lord came back again. And he told him to get up because Jezebel was after him. And he said, go forth and stand. He said, and he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, and slain the prophets with a sword. And I, even I, only am left, that they seek my life to take it away. He said, I am the only one that is left. I am the only prophet. And God told him, I have many that have not denied me. When you read down, he said, God told him, go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great strong wind blew. And after the earthquake, and it was so, when Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in a mantle and went out and stood in the entrance of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, what dost thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, because the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, slain the prophets, and I am left, and I seek my life to take it. And the Lord said unto him, go, return on thy way to the wilderness of Damascus. When thou come, anoint Hazael to be king of Syria, and Jehu. And so God told him, and it came to pass that him that escapes the sword of Jehu slain him that escaped the sword of the sword. And God said that, yet I have left more 7,000 in Israel, all the knees which have not bowed to bow. You think he was the only one? Don't think you are the only one that going through what you are going through. There are many people who are going through worse things that you are going through, but they have not bowed their feet. They have not bowed their feet. They are holding on to the cross. They know the God. Don't bow your feet. Don't bow. Don't throw in the towel. Don't throw in the towel. Hold on to Jesus. You have an anchor that keeps the soul. The Bible says the Lord responded with a compassion by feeding him, correcting him in grace, and giving him a new purpose before he was taken to heaven on the chariots of fire. Three things that God did for him. God fed him. He was running away. God fed him with compassion. God corrected him. Don't say you are the only one. I have 7,000. So if you don't want to worship God, don't think everybody don't want to worship God. I remember I went to a place and I met a man, a white man. I went to preach. I went to work and I met him. I was just standing there and my eyes, tears were coming. How passionate the man was preaching the word of God. He was going, he want everybody to receive the word, and he was giving his testimony. Then you tell me that it is a white man's gospel. Poor you need repentance. You need repentance. You need salvation. May the Lord forgive you. Come to Jesus Christ. The next person that went through, his face was tested, was Thomas, a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thomas was with Jesus Christ. He walked with Jesus Christ. He ate with them. But his face was tested. And so we call him the doubting Thomas. I am talking about the characters in the Bible that went through, they rested with their faith. When they were tempted, when they went through troubles, yes, till they won. When you look to Peter, it came to a time in Acts of the Apostle chapter 4 and the verse 12, when the Holy Spirit, when they were baptized with the Holy Spirit, and they took him before the Sanhedrin, and they told him to deny Jesus Christ. In Acts of the Apostle chapter 4 and the verse 11, this is the stone which, when you start from verse 8, it said, then Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost, said unto them, ye rulers of the people, the elders of Israel, if we this day be examined of the good deed done to the impotent man, by what means he is made whole, be it known unto you all, and to all the people of Israel, that by the name Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who you crucified, whom God raised from dead, even by him do this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set at the nail of you builders, which has become the head of the cornerstone. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given unto man whereby we must be saved. The boldness, it takes the Holy Spirit. Thomas was with Jesus Christ. Thomas was doubting. Being a disciple of Jesus doesn't automatically make one faith giant. Following Jesus Christ does not make your faith giant. Accepting Jesus Christ, you have to build your faith, your most holy faith. Let me go and read Jude chapter 1. And let me read Jude, this one verse. Let me read verse 20. It said, but ye, beloved, build up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy. You have to build it up. You have to build it up. You have to build your faith through prayer, through the word of God, through meditating, waiting on the Lord. Build your most holy faith. Being a disciple, coming to the Lord Jesus Christ, that not give you a gigantic faith to overcome storms. You go through. Thomas became known as the doubting Thomas because he rested with the truth that Jesus rose from the dead. When you read John chapter 14, when Jesus Christ was telling them, I go to prepare a place, let me go and read, and you see how Thomas doubted, and will come back. John chapter 14, Jesus told them, in my Father's house there are many mansions, I go to prepare a place, I will come back again. And if I go and prepare the place for you, I will come and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you be. Verse 4, it says, and where I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not where thou goest. How can we know? Always Thomas. He said, no, we don't know. He was walking with Jesus Christ, the doubting Thomas. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth. He was walking with Jesus Christ, but still was doubting. He did not know how he would go to heaven. Jesus told him, I am the way, the truth, and life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Let's go to John chapter 20. And we see when Jesus resurrected from death, verse 24. And they told him he was not there when Jesus met them. And he was told that Jesus have shown himself. Let's go in here. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Demas, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciple therefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, except I see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and trust my hands into his side, I will not believe. What proved you mean? There are some people yesterday I was listening to somebody who posted Obinim. Obinim was saying some things And I pray that they will repent. The sad thing is that God can visit them for them to repent. But look at the number of people they have led to hell. Look at the number of people. He was saying that whoever wrote that Jesus Christ was tempted, it was Jesus and only the disciples. And who was there? And how did they know that Jesus was tempted? And he was saying some things. I was just listening to him. They need repentance. They need repentance. They need repentance. May God forgive them. May God forgive them. May God forgive them. We pray for them that they will not lead the whole world into hell before they repent. Thomas was doubting. If you say Jesus has resurrected, three things I want to see. One, I want to see the hands of the nail. When I see it, not only. Two, I want to put my hands in the where the nails were. And three, I want to feel his side where they pierced him. He was doubting. Maybe you are doubting our Jesus. You are doubting our Jesus. You are saying that we don't have a Jesus. He died. May God forgive you. May God forgive you. And may God open your eyes. I've heard many, many people who give testimony how they encountered Jesus Christ. I recently had a testimony of a Nigerian Muslim guy. Among the lot of his family, among the lot of the Muslim congregation, he was the one that Jesus visited. It's through grace. It's through grace. If you have received Christ, it's through grace. Hallelujah. And after 8 days, again the disciples were with him, and Thomas were with them. Then came Jesus, and the door being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, "Peace be unto you." Then said he to Thomas, "Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hands, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing." Jesus Christ told Thomas, "This is my hand, this is my side, feel it." And Thomas answered and said unto him, "My Lord, my God." And Jesus said unto him, "Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen, yet they have believed." Blessed are they that have not seen, but yet they believe. Believe in the Lord Jesus. Christ will need you already. My brother, my sister, believe in the Lord. You and your household will live forever. What are you going through? I have a lot of characters to talk about. And they waver through their faith. But yesterday, many of them, but time will not permit us. We will continue tomorrow. Storms are tests of faith. We go through it to test our faith. Jesus Christ was in the boat. Yes, they were tested. But he spoke to the wind. Don't let anything separate you from the love of Christ. Let's hold on and continue to pray. Our Jesus is alive. Again, our Jesus is alive. May the Lord bless you. We always don't want to end before we pray. We want to lead somebody to Christ. Jesus said, if one person come to Christ, angels rejoice. Many angels rejoice. They rejoice for Christ. Because of his death and resurrection, you come to him, you will rejoice. We always want to lead somebody to the Lord Jesus Christ. Accept him, and you and your household will live forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Say this after me. Say, "Lord Jesus, today I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Father, your word says, if anybody be in you, he is a new creature. All things are past. Everything has become new. As I've accepted you, and everything become new. May you order my steps until you come or call me from this earth in Jesus' name." Always find a church. Find a church and go and worship and fellowship. A church, not every church you go, there are some church. It's like a cemetery. They pour water on the dry bones. Don't go to a church where the man of God that is leading the church is a man married to a woman, a woman married to a woman. Go to a place where you find the Spirit of God, the presence of God. Go to a place where salvation is preached. Go to a place where they will tell you about heaven and hell. Go to a place that they will tell you not to live in your sin. Don't go to any place that they will just encourage you and take your money. Hallelujah. If you live around Houston, Texas, and you're looking for a church, a place of worship, we have started a church. It is not our church, it's the church of God. Come and let's worship God together. Hallelujah. I always tell people, come and let's serve God together. You are not coming to help us. You are coming so that we will join together and serve the Lord. And serve the Lord that we will go to heaven. God bless you. Amen. If you're looking for our address, it's 14113 South Main. It's Houston, Texas. And the zip code is 77035. Again, if you're looking for our address, it's 77035. That is the zip code. 14113 South Main. The suit is A. Houston, Texas. And the zip code is 77035. If you're looking for my number, it's 571-722-8608. Again, my number is 571-722-8608. And if you're looking for my brother, the Pastor Steve Jr., his number is 713-202-1147. You can call us for advice, for prayers, for anything. It is free. We don't charge anybody for anything. And so you can call us and we'll pray with you. God bless you. Let's enter into a time of prayer. Begin to pray. Just open your mouth and begin to thank God. Just thank God. Bless the name of our Lord. Just thank God. Bless his name. Bless the name of our Lord. Bless the name of our Lord. Say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Just thank God for your life. Thank God. Bless the name of our Lord. Rakabandi dibidia. Rondika baba zindereboro. Ebrandi zibra korolobria kadaba. Andereboro. Somebody bless the name of our Lord. Just thank God. Just thank God. Just thank God. Just thank God. Bless his name. Rika da bonda raba. Andere boronda priada ba. Rika da bo jebrinda ka zebra. Andere boro. Ebrandi zika tata bandere bo. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Somebody thank God. Bless God. Just lift the name of our Lord higher. Bless his name. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. Thank God. Open your mouth and thank God. Rika da da bojende rebe, brande re boronda priaka da ba, ande re boronda priada ba, ezende rebe de priada bojeta da ba, brandi korodo priaka da ba. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, rika da da bojende reba. Father, we thank you, we thank you. In the name of Jesus, I want us to pray. There are some times the pain and the trouble that you go through will always rest on your feet. It is not easy. You see that there are many of them, many to mention, that will rest on their feet. Not that they do not believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, but because of what they went through. At times you can go through some situation that will cause you to rest on your feet because of the pain that is attached. But we want to pray with you. We are praying. We want to pray with you. God bless you, man of God. We are praying. Praying. We are asking God that anything that is causing us to wrestle with our faith, we are praying that the Lord will strengthen us. The Lord will help us. The Lord will uphold us in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Say, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, help me. Father of the sick world, ask Jesus to help. Help my faith. Help increase my faith. At times we need the help of God. We need him. We need him in the time of our trouble, in the time of pain, in the time of what we are going through. We need the hand. We need the Holy Spirit to strengthen us. We need it. Open your mouth and let's pray. We are praying in the name of Jesus. Somebody, we are praying. We are calling on the Holy Spirit. We are calling the name of our Lord. We need the help of God. We need the help of Lord. We need the help of our God. We need the help. Somebody pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, she cut over Ricada Bandere Boro Zibrande Corona Priadaba. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray with her Ricardo Buji Brandas and Ereme, a Pandiza Branda, Opioma Vence, Lord, help me in this trouble, in this pain, in this calamity. I pray for your hand, I pray for your strength. The Bible says, with flattery, they will corrupt many, but they that know their God, in time of trouble, in time of pain, you they that know their God, they shall be strong. We pray for the Holy Ghost. The Bible says we shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come upon us. We are praying for the strength of heaven. I call it the strength of heaven. I call it the power of heaven. It is the Holy Ghost that came to strengthen the apostle, that came to empower them, that came to propel them for the mission that they were called to. We pray in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray with us. Pray and say, Lord Jesus, Papa strengthen us. Papa strengthen us. In this time, we are calling the name of Jesus. Pray. Rikata bandide moro. Bandi zibrante korono riadaba. Papa bazita te korono. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Pray. We are praying that God strengthen us and increase our faith. Whoever is struggling with his faith, whatever you are going through, we pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray with us. Say, Lord Jesus, strengthen him. In this time, we pray for the strength of heaven. We pray for the power of God. In the name of Jesus. 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 Rikada da burunda priada ba. Andora burunda priaka da bujende rebe. Rikata taba yente reba. Rondi di midia karabojo. Andere burundi priaka da zende rebe. Opio ma fese lo strengthen me in this time of pain, in this time of my trouble, in this time whatever I'm going through, I pray for your strength. I pray for you, Holy Spirit, fill me with your power. Rikata tabu jendere me roba yeka baba andere borunde priada ba ezikandoro borunda. In the name of Jesus, there's a race that I must run, and a victory is to be won. Give me power every hour to be through. Oh, keep me through, Lord Jesus. Keep me through. Keep me through. Lord Jesus, keep me through. There's a race that I must run, and some victories to be won. Oh, give me power every hour to be true. We are praying. There are some people, many people, whatever you are going through, the storm that you are going through is not intentional. But somebody somewhere is fighting your life to cause you to fail. Somebody somewhere is waging war against you. Always want to increase the trouble of your life. We are praying. We are praying. Again, let me go and read the scripture. And we will stand on this word of God and pray. We are going to read Psalm 68. Psalm 68 and the verse 1 and 2. We are praying with the word of God. He said, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before. As a smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melt before fire, so let the wicked perish at thy presence. Whoever continue to pursue your life, they follow your life, they want you to fail. They don't want good thing to come to you. They want you to always walk in disgrace. They don't want you to see any good thing. They don't want, they want you to remain in that distress, in that pain, in that problem. They don't want that sickness to go. They are doing everything possible because they have shown the sickness. They think that that sickness will kill you. They think that that childless will cause you to think and think and think and destroy that family. They think that causing a divorce in your home can cause you to lose your faith. We are praying. Wherever they are, let the tender of God locate them. Let the Spirit of God crush them wherever they are hiding, in their holes, in their homes, in their secret places, within the spiritual realm, wherever they are. Command the fire. The Bible says, let our God arise. We are praying against them. Let the thunder of Jehovah, it needs a penta evil spirit, the witch will father. I pray, say this, Lord Jesus, whoever is behind my trouble, any spirit, witches or wizard, from my mother's family, from my father's family, from my friends, my community, my neighborhood, my church, from my everyone, my relatives, let your fire locate them. Let the thunder of God locate them. Let the Spirit of God strike them. In the name of Jesus, let them fall in their pit. If they set a trap, let their trap catch them. If they dig a demonic prison to hide me, I exchange my soul with their soul. Let their soul be caught in that demonic prison. Every demonic cage that they have made for me, I exchange it with them. I let them be found in that demonic cage. Let the thunder of God strike them. Let the fire of Jehovah consume them. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Whoever is behind the trouble of your life, whoever is behind the pain, the sickness, Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, remember Satan was behind Job's problem. Satan was behind Job's problem. Job was going through everything he went through because of Satan. I've considered him. We are praying, everyone that have considered you to be destroyed, everyone that have considered you to go through pain, everyone that have considered you, oh Jesus, Father, we pray repentance for them. But the spirit that is using them, your word says we shall resist the devil and he'll flee from us. We come against that demon, we come against that witch spirit, we come against that occult spirit, we come against that demonic shrine. We pray in the name of Jesus. Rika katabade is a brand to kontorobora, he can deriva is a brand he can torobo. I command the Holy Ghost fire into that secret occult place. I command the Holy Spirit into that one that have crossed his leg to receive the Holy Ghost fire. I command the tender of God fire to locate the witches in our mother's, our father's, and our family in the neighborhood. Receive the fire of the Holy Ghost. Receive the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Rekata bojendereba abrandere boronda riadaba. In the name of Jesus, 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 in the name, somebody pray. Pray with us. Rekata banderiba librande. I pray to the community of Houston, every serpentine spirit. I pray to the churches, every demon, every witch, everyone that is hiding behind a cover, fighting our lives and our destiny. Let them receive fire. I command tender. Rekata bojendereba. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, somebody pray with us, somebody call the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, 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 somebody pray, pray, come on, fire, 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 whoever is fighting your life, fighting, oh Jesus, Baba, I pray, whoever has crossed their legs, whoever is chanting against us, every demonic spirit, every witchcraft spirit, receive fire, fire. Let the tender of Jehovah Christ them. Rakado bojen de briadaba. E babanda zindere boron de briadaba. E zikandoro boron de briadaba. Somebody pray. We are praying in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. Rekata bojenderebe. Abandere borunda priada baje karodobo. Azendere borunda. E brandidi badara borundi kata bojenderebe. E brandere boru. Andere boru kata bandere borunda. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. Rekata bojenderebe. Ezibriada In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we are praying for those who need divine intervention. Maybe you need the hand of Jehovah in your situation, in the life of your children, in your life, that sickness. You need God's hand. You need healing touch from the Holy Spirit. There are some people that need divine intervention in their lives, in their documents, in your marriages, your relationship, in your family's life. We are praying against every spirit that is waging war. Let the hand of Jehovah bring the divine intervention, bring salvation, bring happiness, take away that pain, that trouble, that sickness. May the Lord cause that womb to carry a child in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and let's begin to pray. We are praying for you. We are praying with you. We are praying in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Bandezunda Briadaba, a contoro Borunda, a brandizendereba Briadabo, and the Reborunda Briada Boshin Derebe, a contoro Borunda Briadaba, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, a bandere Borunda, and the Reborunda Briacada Boshin de Briadaba, Ricada Boshin Dereba, Ricada Bono Briada Banda Zenderebe, Ricada Boshin Derebe, Ricato Boshin de Briada. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus, Rikada Borunda Priadaba, Ebabu Genere Borunda Priadaba, Andere Boru, Opioma, we are praying. Father, I stand in the gap. You sought for a man to stand in the gap. You found a noun. Today, I stand in the gap on behalf of your people, our listeners, our viewers. Father, those who are sick, I pray healing, I pray healing. I pray healing. Father, heal whoever is praying for your healing. Your word says, by your stripes we are healed. Father, I pray. I come against any demonic sickness, spirit of high blood pressure, diabetes, receive fire. I cast you out. I cast you. I command you wherever it's coming from. Father, we pray for healing for your people. Every COVID, whoever is praying with that, I pray healing over your life. Every cancer spirit, Rikata Bojen Deriba, Rande Kanzon Dorobo Ronda Priadaba, Itakandorobo, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Rikata Tabandere Borunda, Ebrandi Karada Bronda Bazenderebe, Ebabandere Borunda, Rikata Borunda Priada Bojen Deribe, Epanta Zenderebe, Rikata. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, somebody pray. We pray in the name of Jesus. Rekada da bojendere bide, ebrandere borunda priada babanda zendere be, ababandere borunda, andere burakada bojendere be. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus, ibandere boru, ebrandi kandara barande. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray with us. We pray in the name of Jesus. Father, pray healing for your people. I pray healing. Rekata Bojende Riba, Ronde Priada Bojende Riba, Ronde Priada Bojende Riba. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Somebody, we are praying healing in the name of Jesus. Ronde Priada Bojende Riba, Rekata Bojende Priada Ba, Ezibranti Korobo, Zabra. In the name of Jesus, 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 Rikata Bojenderebe, Rikaboza Branderebe, and Dereboronda Briadaba, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for your people. Let's pray our last prayer. We are praying and committing the rest of our days in the year. May the Lord God protect you. May the Lord guide you. We are praying for you, your family, your children, your husband, your wife. We are praying that the Holy Spirit will be a permanent wall of fire around you. We are praying that the Lord will protect you. David said, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord shepherd David, protected David. May God protect you in the name of Jesus. We cancel every demonic plans concerning your life. We cancel it in the name of Jesus. We are praying our last prayer. We are lifting you. May the Lord cover you. And also we pray that the will of God, the purpose of God for your life, will come to pass in the name of Jesus. Prayer, let's pray our last prayer. Mantere boronda, abandere boronda priada ba, ezintere be, rakate boje brandi kada ba. Father, we commit your people, our listeners. Father, we stand in the gap. We pray for your divine protection. We pray that the Holy Ghost, your blood, will be a permanent wall of fire around them. Protect them, protect their children, protect their husbands, protect their wife, protect their mothers, their fathers. We come against every demonic plan, everything that the enemy has set against your life. We destroy it. The Bible says, by your stripes we are healed. We pray healing over every soul. We pray in the name of Jesus. We pray for our children. We pray for our boys. We pray for our girls. We pray for our wives. We pray for our husbands. We pray that, Lord, you be with them. May the Lord God strengthen you. May the Lord God watch over you. May the Lord God protect you in the name of Jesus Christ, 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 in the name of Jesus Christ. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you, men and women of God, for your time with us, for taking your time. There are some people, if we're thanking God, we always also want to thank you. Let me thank my big sister, Sister Adelaide. Sister Adelaide, God bless you. I love you with the love of God. May the Lord always use it as a key and fulfill every heart desire. May God answer your prayer for helping your brothers to propagate the gospel. We stand together. May God face shine upon you and give you peace in the name of Jesus. I also want to thank the woman of God and the man of God, Mama Janice Akrofi, and the bishop, my apostle, a brother for another mother. We labor together. We labor to win souls together. Bishop and Mama Akrofi and Akrofi, God bless you for your love. You always stand with us. We appreciate you. And also let me not forget somebody that God divinely have given unto me, my brother. He always stand with me. And God bless you, Pastor Steve Grant Jr. Amen, Mama Crofty. God bless you. And the wife, Mommy Josephine Benjamin Grant. God bless you. I always thank God for you and your wife's life. And it's a blessing. And people who are watching us afar, and I say, God bless you, my dear. People who are watching us from far and near, we thank God for everyone. We love you all with the love of God. Share our messages for us, and let's win the world together for Christ. In Jesus' name. Bye. See you the same time tomorrow. Bye. And also, let me not forget Pastor Comfort Mensah. God bless you, woman of God. God bless you all for everything. In Jesus' name. Bye-bye.